G'day team. Talking a little bit of technical work again this week, but thought it would be a little bit more food for thought. So we're talking about your standards in regards to how you start movement versus how you finish. So start with the same standard you'd like to finish with. Really, really important. I've put some of the main movements up for it, and I've pictured the snatch because it's what some of you guys will start working towards. But this is applicable for any kind of movement as well. But clean's the big one, squats, deadlift, lunge, and snatch, which is pigeon. So I thought I'd use a snatch example today. Starting position, the middle part of your pull or your lift, and then your ending position. So we want to make sure that before we do a movement, we have got our body and the bar in a position where we're completely set up to have a successful lift. Because if there is something that's gone wrong in the end of your lift, it's likely it's been initiated at the start. Not always the case, but usually in regards to a technical fault rather than any kind of like injury that you previously had, it's usually something that we can look at the start and fix up at the start of your lift. So big ones for your Olympic lifts, I could go on all day about these, but I'll just keep it really short. So eyes forward, which is a really important one. So applicable to anything else, think about where you want your eyes or your gaze to be when you do any kind of movement. If I am in a back squat, for example, and I keep myself looking down, all I'm going to do is encourage myself to come forwards, which is going to change my squat. Whereas if I keep my eyes above my forehead and I sit into my squat, it will change, one, the way my spine posture is. If I'm looking down, I'm going to start rounding at the top of my spine. But then it also encourages you to think about where you're going at the end of your lift. So eyes for Olympic lifting are always forwards and never want to be looking down. So you start your lift looking down, you're probably not going to have a great lift, or you're not going to have your most successful lift. Shoulders over the bar. So another generic one can be bar positioning. Where are you in relation to your equipment? For Olympic lifting, shoulders always going to be just forward of the bar. This means that when we go for our pull position, we are going to end up in a nice straight line. So if my shoulders started behind the bar, when I go to pull, I'm probably going to throw the weight back, or I'm going to compensate and catch it forwards. So shoulder positioning is really important with Olympic lifting. And then in regards to any other movement, where is your bar? Where is the position in regards to where you are? Deadlift is really important, okay? We want to close the gap and keep everything nice and close. So if you're trying to deadlift a bar that's a gap away from you, you're probably going to find your lower back's going to jump in and help. Same with a front rack for a squat, really important how you position that bar. Same with the back squat as well. This one's a really, really important one, which I think we almost don't talk about as much, but ground your feet. Okay, we want to make sure that we've got even footing. This comes down to not only your footwear, whatever you're doing. So I've talked to a couple of you guys about when you're lifting, making sure you've got shoes that help you ground into the floor. If you're trying to do lifting in a runner, where you've got a lot of cushy support, it's like kind of trying to lift on marshmallows. Like you're not going to have as much feedback. So part of that is making sure you've got the correct footwear to be grounded, and then the other part is just making sure you've got presence. Like, where is your weight sitting in your feet? Is it primarily sitting in the front of your feet? Is it primarily sitting only in your heels and you're lifting your toes, which means you're not quite even either? Or are you kind of like mid-foot with presence in the heels, so completely grounded through the feet? Really, really important for Ollie lifting, because obviously your footwork has a really important part to play in the pattern of your lift. But then also when it comes to a squat or a deadlift, we also know that where you place your feet is super important. If I was to just set up aimlessly for a squat, my knees are going to go, or try and go where my toes are, or if I set up with a really weird stance, like my knees might not be able to go where I want them to go, which is over my toes. So those are three really important things to think about that also help you finish your lift really successfully. There's obviously more that I can go on with, but how you start something will be how you finish. So the best thing for you to do if you're not feeling like you're achieving the lift that you want is to look first where you're starting. I think a really beneficial thing is to film yourself. never be angry at anybody in class if you wanted to film the way you're moving in a deadlift or the way you're moving in an ollie lift, because sometimes you aren't aware of your body until you actually see it. So I think that filming yourself is a really, really beneficial way to learn about what your body's doing if you can't see it. But then also visiting yourself, maybe using the mirror for a little bit of guidance if you need it at one point. Or asking a coach to have a look at your setup for anything if, you know, your deadlift doesn't